A wave of earnings reports from local corporations today, beginning with Jollibee posting a 31% growth in its second quarter earnings, bringing its first half profit to 5.7 billion pesos. The fast food giant says its businesses, Jollibee, Chowking, and Mang Inasal, outperformed system-wide sales targets with robust growth in Europe, the Middle East, and North America. Its coffee and tea business also showing improvement, with the Coffee Bean and Tea Leaf system-wide sales growing over 25% during the second quarter. As for Blueberry Resorts, it saw its net income drop 62% in the second quarter due to continued weakness in its VIP segment. This was partially offset by a 3% growth of combined mass, table, and electronic gaming machine revenues across Soleil Resort Entertainment City and Soleil Resort North. Excluding the impact of Soleil North's pre-operating expenses, consolidated EBITDA would have dropped 20% instead of 33%. And Ayala Corporation's first half earnings jumps 21% thanks to stronger contributions from BPI, Ayala Land, Globe, and ASIN. Excluding one-off items, its core net income grew 18% to 24.3 billion pesos. Now here are other earnings reports released today. The Philippine finance chief admits the country's sovereign wealth fund is still scouting for its first investments. This is as he bared during a budget hearing at the Senate that Maharlika Investment Fund has no allocation in the proposed 6.35 trillion peso spending plan for 2025.
There is no subsidy in the 2025 NEP for Maharlika. Admittedly, it is taking time to identify investments that the Maharlika can make. As you know, it is like a startup. They're looking for employees. We're determining the pay packages to be given to the employees of the Maharlika, and they're scouting for investments.
Union workers at the world's biggest copper mine in Chile go on strike. That's after they failed to reach an agreement with Australian mining giant BHP over their demand for a bigger slice of copper profits, which have been boosted by recent high prices. BHP says it has removed striking workers at the Escondida mine to allow operations to continue. In 2017, a 44-day strike by mine workers paralyzed operations, resulting in losses of some $740 million and driving up global copper prices. Shares of BHP sank 2.7% Wednesday, while fellow Australian miner Rio Tinto, which owns a 30% stake in Escondida, saw its stock slump 2.6%.